Good morning, my dear student. Today in our class, we are going to revise the chapter number 4, addition and subtraction. Very soon, you are going to get the test of this chapter, subjective and objective. So to score the better marks in the test, let us revise the chapter.
We already know that the numbers we add are called addends, and the answer we get after adding is called the sum. For example, here 23,484 and 56,710 are addends, and after adding these two numbers we will get 80,194, which is known as the sum. Now let us revise the properties of addition. First property is commutative property, second is associative property, and third is zero property. First is commutative property. When two numbers are added, the sum is the same regardless of the order of the addends. For example, let us take two numbers 351 and 504. So either we will write 351 plus 504 or 504 plus 351, we will always get the same answer, that is 855. Second is associative property. When three or more numbers are added, the sum is the same regardless of the grouping of the addends. Numbers 10, 30 and 50. In the first case, we will group 10 and 30 together and that sum we will add to 50. In the second case, we will group 30 and 50 together and that sum we will add to 10. In both the case, we will get the sum 90. So either we will group first two numbers or the last two numbers. The sum of three numbers will always remain same. Now coming to the third property, that is zero property. The sum of any number and zero is always the number itself. For example, 19 plus 0 is equals to 19 and 0 plus 5 is equals to 5. So whenever we will add 0 to any number, we will get the number itself. We already know that the subtraction means taking away of a number from a given amount. So the term taken away and find the difference imply subtraction. We find how many left, how many more, how many less than, and difference of through subtraction only. A number from which another number is subtracted is called the minuend, and the number that is subtracted is called the subtrahend. And the answer we get after the subtraction is called the difference. Students, always remember, when the minuend is same as subtrahend, the difference is always zero. For example, 25 minus 25 is equals to 0. And when the 0 is subtrahend, the difference is the minuend only. Example, 25 minus 0 is equals to 25. Addition and subtraction are inverse relations. Inverse means opposite. So it means that when two numbers are added, we get the sum of two numbers. If we subtract any one number from the sum, we get the other number. For example, 5 plus 2 is equals to 7. By adding 5 and 2, we get 7. Now we will use inverse operation of the same equation by subtracting 2 from the answer. Here 7 minus 2 is equals to 5, and we can also write 7 minus 5, which is equals to 2. Addition and subtraction are opposite operations in mathematics. So you can use one to check the answer of the other number. For example, 2 plus 3 is equals to 5 and 5 minus 3 is equals to 2. The first way says, if we start with 2 and add 3, we get 5. The second one says, if we start with 5 and take away 3, we get 2. So we are just playing with the same numbers forward and backward. Now let us take one more example. Subtract 12,406 from 37,638 and check your answer. First of all, place the numbers in the place value chart. Starting from the right hand side, ones place, 8 minus 6 is equals to 2. In the tens column, 3 minus 0 is 3. In 100 column, 6 minus 4 is 2. In 1000 column, 7 minus 2 is 5. 3 minus 1 is 2. Now to check the answer, we will add the difference and the subtrahend. So after adding 12,406 and 25,232, we will get the minuend, which is 37,638. Now we can say the difference of minuend and subtrahend is correct, as the addition of difference and subtrahend is minuend. Therefore, to check if the answer to a subtraction problem is correct, we add the difference to the smaller number to get the larger number.
Thank you for watching the video. I hope you understood the chapter. Try to do the written practice of the chapter number 4 in your rough notebook. See you soon in the next video. Till that time, take care.